When spirits communicate, they do so in many different ways. Some open and close doors, others make lights flicker. The easiest way to understand what a spirit is trying to tell us is through a written message, which we're going to do with this chalkboard and chalk. Keep a nice firm grip like you have there, Brian. We're going to place this hood back over your face just for a few moments. Great. Are you ready for this? Yes? So am I. Ladies, are you ready? It is now time. Go!
The Illusion Show, I've been touring since I was about 18 years old. Started off with a lot of homemade props, tour around, pulling a U-Haul trailer. And then over the years, it evolved to taking the show to various places around the United States and eventually out of the country. So right now, at this point, I've been doing this for approximately 12 years, touring with The Illusion Show. The most unique places I've been to have been when I performed for the troops. I'm doing overseas performances for the soldiers. And one of the first places they sent me was Iceland. That was definitely a unique place to go, to say the least. There was nothing there except for basically snow and a base. On the other side of the spectrum, I've had the opportunity to do a cruise. It was the first cruise for this particular cruise line I was on, Princess, I believe, where we got to tour from going from Cape Town, Africa, to Antarctica. Working as an illusionist and making a living, and of course everyone's definition of a comfortable living is going to be different, but you know, if you want to make comparable income to let's say a teacher or a doctor even, you know, if you're going to go to the real world and say this is what I do, this is all that I do, you have to work constantly. Me doing the Illusion Show, I find that higher end theme parks, casinos, and corporate is what we need to do to maintain that. And the biggest thing, and this was taught from Harry himself, Blackstone, when I toured with him as an understudy, was it's show business. You need to know the show, but you most importantly need to know the business. How does one run a company, understand contracts, law, negotiation, and most importantly sales. You know, dealing with clients on a regular basis to generate those sales, pitch them over the comedian or band that most venues in the casino world that I'm dealing with would have, you know, and figure out how to make magic what they want verbally and then close the deal. Very difficult, but if you master it, you'll make a very good living. When we do the Illusion Show, we have approximately 6 people that will be on my staff, meaning that they have been trained in all the safety issues, how illusions are set up correctly and broken down, and then the execution of the illusion on stage, whether they're a dancer getting into a prop or a tech pushing something on or off, all that sort of thing. The venue then is required to supply me with usually additional 8 people. So it takes about 14 of us to pull off an average show, which is a very loose term because a lot of shows are customized, you know, to the venue size or what have you. And then all those people at the venue would be responsible for doing spots, sound, and this sort of thing. And then there'd be a couple of my tech people that would sit with them during the show, manage their work, and help them through the performance.
The
You have to be prepared for anything. When you're doing traveling as often as we do, you know, sometimes we've gone Michigan to Vegas, Vegas to South Carolina, South Carolina to New York, and that was in a week and a half. And it's all driving. There was no one flew. And when you're doing that, you're going to have tires that blow out. You're going to have people that are going to get sick. You're going to have all sorts of things that are just going to happen just naturally in life that you have to now figure out, how do you deal with someone cut their finger? Where's the hospital? I have no concept where the hospital is around me, you know. Something breaks. You take so many tools with you and supplies, but there's going to be a point in time where something breaks that's going to be beyond your means to fix easily, to find a welder or what have you. When transporting the equipment, the first concern always logistically, how do we get everything to play the show as large as the client has requested, but at the same time logistically keep our expenses as low as possible? Which again, going back to business, is a business model. And that's, you know, a philosophy that we follow very carefully. I own my own, it's a 30-foot trailer, it's the kind that you put like a NASCAR in. So our goal is always to try and make whichever show the client's buying fit into that trailer, which means possibly having the props having to break down quite a bit and fold up and legs coming off and this sort of thing. But in the long run, it's cheaper for me to do that and have another tech to help set it up when we get there, opposed to having another vehicle. And when the best way, in my opinion, that we found expense-wise is that you pull that trailer then with like a Suburban or a large pickup truck. With all the bookings, I handle it with myself and a full-time business partner. And handling it means two different things. Either we will personally call a client directly, we'll call XYZ Casino, we'll research their information on the website, see what kind of entertainment they have, if they even have existing entertainment. If they do, then we'll approach them with the idea of having me perform there. This is a little trick that you do is, you know, depending on the size of the casino, it's better for me just to call them and say, I'd love to bring my show there. It's a big casino, and they have Jay Leno last week, let's say, and we know we're gonna be shooting for the stars, or we're going to shoot. Then my manager will call, because, of course, I'm too busy to make the phone call. A lot of times it's me acting like my manager. but the perceived value of that is actually quite large, especially so you just kind of feel out the situation where you are. Then I have agents, and the agents I'll sign non-exclusives with, or I will not sign an exclusive agreement with. They are simply just working for a percentage base of what they get. Most of them are what we call order takers. You know, they just, if someone calls in for magic, they have four magicians, they call the four magicians, see who's available, and who would do the cheapest. And those people are, they're nice to have around, but you can't rely on them for a healthy income. You need to go out after on your own. And that's something that we do every day, Monday through Friday, from hotel rooms, from cars, from cruise lines. You're constantly on the phone selling during business hours. My biggest advice for someone who would like to tour with their own illusion show is to start on the simple side. Doesn't necessarily mean it has to be small, but it needs to be simple. Not having illusions that require a lot of complicated setup and rigging. Go in there, make it so that you can do it for at least a 180-degree audience, maybe 360. Because then you go there, you have to worry about your angles, prop self-contained, you know, make your cloths thick so if the light's behind you, don't make it sheer or make it translucent, make it so it's opaque. You go in there with that mindset, simple illusion show, you're going to find that you're able to concentrate on performing it opposed to problem-solving the whole time you're at the venue. Thank you. for me personally, I find people that have connected with something on stage, which is a bizarre thing. They have someone that you do not know that found something about your performance that they liked. It's a huge compliment, probably the biggest you can get. And we'll send you emails, photos they took of, you know, going to performances. They'll go to different spots where you're performing on the road, which is terrific. And we have actually a very healthy dose of those kind of people that we love to have around. Having the fan base, it's a wonderful thing to see that you've connected with somebody on a level where they appreciate your work so much they're willing to go beyond just applauding in the theater.